Hello, everybody. I don't know what possessed me to do a super stream on Easter weekend, but here we are. I am not only streaming 3 days this weekend, but I am also hosting Easter on Sunday, so I've got a lot to do. On top of that, I've got a blog due, and I've got calendars due, and I have a bullet journal to prepare, and a show to prepare for. So, I don't know that I'm sleeping this weekend, but we'll get started. We'll get some of this stuff done. Tonight I'm going to really appreciate user participation, or viewer participation. I have this product in mind, but I'm not quite sure what color to go with. So anyone that has an opinion is more than welcome to chime in. Over the super stream, I'm doing 3 wedding themed projects. Because I feel like dolls in their dollhouses get married too. And I don't usually see wedding things besides like a cake or like a gown. So I thought I'd do something fun. So I ordered these laser cut letters. Now, I don't typically do laser cutting. I have maybe 1 or 2 other products that I have ordered laser cut things for, but I don't do it. But I don't know how, I don't have the time to make them any other way. So, I'm thinking I have the letters to spell out I do. I figured they would be on a 2-inch platform. Alright. A little bit further away, a little bit closer together. And then I can't decide if I want to do gold or silver or just white. I think just white. And then I was thinking about, I got these cheapy rhinestones, but they're, I think they'll work for another project that I want to do this weekend. Ooh. But I can't decide if I want to make maybe the O gold or silver with one of these as like, so it looks like a ring. I don't know. So we have some options here. I think all of them could be really cute. I have 10 I can mess around with and do different styles, I guess, but I kind of wanted to know what the viewers thought. Or I'll make one of each and then put it to a vote on Instagram or something. What if I had an exact amount? But I think a 2 foot by these would be 1 foot. 2 inch by 1 inch. That would be a decent decoration for like a buffet or, you know, if you're doing like a wedding party scene or something like that. I think it could work really well. Hopefully this is wide enough that it stands up when I glue it. Gonna sand this end real quick. So how has everybody's Friday been? Mine was pretty decent. We got to go home early from work. Which means I got some stuff done. Mostly yard stuff. Tomorrow will be all like food prep and making sure the bunny drops off the clues for the egg hunt on Sunday. Get my free ham from the grocery store, even though we won't be cooking that ham because I've had ham in my freezer since Christmas. It's time to use that ham. Be the fun part is making sure that it goes in the right spot. So this is what it'll look like, just so you guys can see. Sorry, I thought we weren't getting music there for a second. It isn't popping up on my chat. So, I think we at least try with white first. See where that gets us. I'm gonna paint first and then glue. What else has been going on? I'm trying to chip away at my to-do list for the upcoming shows. Things are happening. Just slow. It'll get done. Or it won't, and that's okay. Maybe we'll just paint one, see if we like it, and then just keep going through colors. Either way, this one will be my prototype. See it because the grains in the wood you're getting a couple of cracks, which could be neat for people looking to do more of that rustic. So maybe I'll take a picture of that. Try not to fill in those cracks too much. And then I'll go back and fill it in. Gonna see something real quick. Oh, hey. It's not Sunday, you're right. It's a super stream. We're doing 3 days in a row because because I forgot that it was Easter weekend. And I decided that I could definitely do everything that I wanted to do this weekend. So I've got this and hosting Easter and everything that goes along with hosting Easter, like cleaning the house and making sure the bunny brings everything to the house. And a whole bunch of other business things that I have to get done. It's gonna be fine. I'm excited for Easter. I am also excited for Easter to be over because then I get a nice lull in events until June. Because what my year looks like, with no break in between, starting we're gonna start in October. October, we do an autumn adventure, my son and I, every year. After the autumn adventure is Halloween, so I've been prepping for Halloween, whether I'm making a costume or prepping candy or just anything in general for Halloween. After Halloween comes Thanksgiving. While I am not relegated to cooking for Thanksgiving anymore, we usually have to find a place to go. Oh, I'm sorry, no. Halloween, Philly Miniatura, then Thanksgiving. By Thanksgiving, I already have about 4 sets of grandparents asking me what my son wants for Christmas. So I have to have all of that ready for Black Friday. Then it is all the Christmas shenanigans, where we have 5 various families that we have to visit or come visit us. Everybody wants their own special time, and we're just trying to, you know, dwindle it down so that we all just have Christmas at our house, but then there's some people that don't get along, and some people that live out of state. So Christmas gets spread in from typically the 21st to the 6th-ish of January. After Christmas is over, it is immediately my son's birthday. After my son's birthday is Valentine's Day, which I do something for both the boys in the house because I think boys deserve Valentine's Day too. Valentine's Day leads into all of the March birthdays I have in my life, of which I can name 12 people off the top of my head I know that have March birthdays. That's not including the people who I typically do not celebrate their birthdays, or do not do anything, or we're not close enough, or anything like that. After March birthdays is Easter. And then I get a nice lull until about June. And then it's in rapid fire succession. My birthday, our anniversary, my husband's birth. No. If we do something for Mother's Day, we don't typically do anything for me for Mother's Day. We do something for Phoenix's mom. So it is Mother's Day, my birthday, Father's Day, my... No. Start over. Mother's Day, my birthday, our anniversary, Father's Day, husband's birthday. And then usually we go on vacation around then, but we probably won't this year. So, and then we'll have a nice lull again. Until October. Because I don't have school anymore, so I don't have to worry about that. But! It's nonstop. And I'm just tired. Just tired. It looks like a J. Like there's no other way to... That wouldn't... Yeah, I guess that would be the eye. Yeah, well, that's everything. And that's not including any of the other small stupid things that I plan on doing throughout the year. Like smaller dollhouse conventions or anything else that comes up. Birthdays, weddings. So when people ask me if I've had a relaxing weekend, the answer is typically no. Even my relaxing weekends, I'm usually doing something that will hopefully eventually lead to me being able to relax. I don't know when that is, but you know, girl can dream. I was telling my husband the other night, I was like, I need to go on vacation. He goes, okay. I said, and like, do nothing. He goes, you don't do nothing on vacation. I'm like, okay. But I want the option to do nothing. Or maybe I want the option to not do anything. Like, There's, like, no Wi-Fi or nothing around. Just put me out in the woods somewhere. Maybe that would be best. Where all I have is to enjoy nature. Doing mom thing. Go to the Caribbean, get one of those huts that you can just walk out on the water and sit on the deck, read a book, listen to audiobook. Yeah. See, I'm the person that brings something to do when I go on vacation. Like, I have a little caboodle that I bring with me of, like, beach safe projects, or, you know, whatever. But that sounds nice. And when given, like, no other option, I just sleep. Yeah. Knit. Yeah. No, I'm trying to get into reading. So that would be good. No, I really want to go to, like, the Finger Lakes in New York. Or just upstate New York in general. I've been eyeing up cabins. Disappear. Go for hikes. Have some campfires. Get some spare cash this summer, we'll go. Alright, so here is our white lettering option. Too shabby. Kinda cute. Gonna take a picture real quick. Cause I think I'm just gonna paint this one and then we're gonna post our options online. So we got white. Thank you. had the option to put like a like it's a ring. Cooperate, please. That's fun. Being a ginger. Don't like the sun because reasons. Go ahead. Yeah. I am not a beach person, but my husband is. I spend all day, every day out in the sun and dirt. And I don't want to do that around a lot of people, because while I am also an extrovert and do not mind the sun and dirt, it's not what I ideally want to do on my break. So as soon as we get to the beach, we set up a little pop-up tent and I scoop myself in and I sit on my chair and I do not leave unless I go to the water directly. I like the boardwalk though. Food, lights, sounds, just all sorts of visual stimuli. But yeah, I don't know, it's just beach. But it's like our cheapest option for vacation. Because we've got family that lives down in Margate. So, can't turn down free. But yeah, definitely. I grew up camping on like the St. Lawrence River in New York, and I miss it so much. There's a part of me, my soul, that just cries to be up there, but I do not have a boating license, so I can't. Alright, now we're gonna try... Let's try... painting this guy gold. See what that looks like. Part of me thinks this is going to look cheesy, but it might also look really cute. But I like to travel. Like, my wanderlust knows no bounds. I could be on vacation and already thinking about where I want to go next. Trying to block the light. There we go. That's kind of fun, huh? Yeah, this could be good vacations. You grew up. That's pretty cool. We used to do cabin camping, which I guess I'm a little spoiled, but it was like really rustic. Like, there were bathrooms, but no showers, and so we had to bathe in the river. Just my dad would fish, and whatever he caught, we would eat. And Mom would cook on the campfire, watch the sunset over the St. Lawrence. It was just to describe it. Soul healing. White base on this though. Have you been fishing or hunting? I grew up doing both, so out. I couldn't afford to get myself my seafood feast this summer, and I am so, so sad. I treat myself to like a dozen crabs and some mussels and some shrimp and some scallops, and I spend the entire afternoon making myself this huge seafood feast. And my husband gets none because my husband wants none, so more for me. Alright, let's see what the silver looks like. Should have done the silver first. Thank you. Last year we did a jam-packed family vacation. We've never gone on a family vacation that wasn't to, like, the beach. So we did this huge Virginia trip, and it was a blast. But I feel like, because, you know, as a mom and wife, and you're trying to navigate two people around that don't quite know what's going on, and they've never been there, and I didn't get to relax. I already don't know that I like the silver at all. I'm thinking the gold's the way to go. We'll see what happens when it tries. Oh, goodness. But in the meanwhile, we'll cut some more bases. Honeymoon, because I didn't bring anything to do with me, because you're supposed to relax, Bailey, when you're on vacation, I just would sleep wherever. I'd find a chair on the cruise, and just, I'd be done for the night, for the day, just sleep. Great. Really concerning for the husband, because I don't sleep. I don't nap. Just like, are you okay? I'm like, probably not. It's fine. My husband is like a small child, though. He naps all the time. He will nap in the car before work. As soon as he gets to work, he takes a nap. He'll nap during his lunch. He'll nap after he gets home from work. And every once in a while, he'll nap. Like, when he was playing WoW a lot, he would then, after dinner, or, like, maybe right before raid, take a quick power nap. Naps all the time. And I only nap when I'm dying. My guy likes to sleep. But ask him to, like, go to bed early or, like, go to bed at a decent time because he wakes up at 5:30 in the morning. No. He gets 8 hours. It's just, you know, sporadically throughout the day. Hence the nickname Sleepy King. Now I think he's only down to like one nap a day. If that. Yeah, I already don't like the silver. It's not gonna coat well. So, I'm thinking the gold, and I'm thinking all of the letters on gold. I really like this. Like, I think it's classy. Having it all in white is a little too bland. I like that. Oh, You know, I don't like being in my 30s because I can just move ever so slightly and something will pop. That did not feel good. That'll be a tension headache later. Cool. I'm a mess. I need a nap. No, you're not. That's. You don't seem like you'd be turning 40, from what I know of you. You're a June birthday, too. Not sadly, 40 will be fine. Early June, late June. Something, something, Gemini, something, something, something. You gonna ring in 40 in a good way, I hope. Have a party. Go dancing. That's what I'm gonna do for my birthday. Not that I'm turning 40, but if I can help it, I'm going out. So jealous. Lucky son of jerk. Have fun, I guess. We almost planned an impromptu trip to Japan because my husband saw that Baby Metal was touring. I told him if he could find lodging, airfare, lodging, and food for under $1,500, we could go. I guess we're not going. That's a dream trip, though. Scotland. One day, man. You know, the saying was that March comes in like a lion and out like a lamb, but I'm still seeing lion-esque traits outside. Why is it 20 mile an hour winds? Why is this okay? It was absolutely frigid this morning. I was not happy. Oh, sorry, just got very engrossed in what I was doing and forgot I was dreaming. Hope the music's been entertaining at least. That's fine. You can get distracted all you want. I have people that tell me that they watch this stream to fall asleep, so either I'm boring or I'm doing something right, I'm not sure.
Thank you.
Do I dare throw a wrench into my plans tomorrow and go get a haircut? That's the question. Since last May, late May, got a good 4 inches that we could take off. It would be nice. Yeah, I have a lot of hair. You should see my husband, though. Holy crap. He stopped cutting his hair probably in the summer. He is rocking some locks right now. He's trying to grow it out to, like, shoulder length, I think. It's long. Looks good on him, though. I think, personally. Oh, he's got some hair. Yeah. Take a picture of him next time I'm in his vicinity. Send it to you. He used to have really long hair when he was in high school. Straight up metalhead kind of long hair. But I was joking and saying, because when we started dating, he had like the skater boy length hair that like curled perfectly around his baseball hat. And I really liked it, and I was like, oh, you should grow that back. Well, he just kept going. So, so, my man's has some hair right now. I think he wants to donate it to Locks of Love or something when he's done. I did that once. I donated my hair and they took it in 4 ponytails. That's how much hair I have. They made 4 separate people very happy. And I would have donated it after I cut it after the wedding, but I still had hair dye in it from when I previously dyed it, so they couldn't take it. Which was a bummer, because I had a lot of hair after the wedding. It was down to 2 inches. glue down prototype. Hope to goodness it stays up. We'll see. I need wood glue. That's definitely something I need. But it looks like we're in the clear. So that's exciting. Now I'm gonna annoy the crap out of people with standing noises. Oh, actually, it's not that bad. thought I was gonna cover these with glitter. I'm glad I didn't. Something is getting covered with glitter this weekend. I'm just not sure when. I get to hard boil about 500,000 eggs tomorrow. That'll be fun. Gonna make the in-laws dye eggs. Come to my house for Easter, you're gonna do fun things. Dyeing eggs. I won't make them go on an egg hunt, but half tempted to. So Rob goes on a basket hunt. The bunny leaves him a basket. Phoenix goes on a scavenger hunt, like clue to clue to clue, to get to his basket. The in-laws are getting baskets this year, because I think everybody should get a basket on Easter. And then my niece is going to, because she's only two, she'll probably just go find eggs in the yard. But see, when I used to hold Easter parties, like, for friends, I would make them all, like, I would fill 250 eggs and throw them out in my dad's yard, and it would be great, because watching 20 to 30-something-year-olds go find eggs is the most hilarious thing on the face of the planet, because they're all so competitive and it's adorable, but Rob would not participate. So I'm not gonna make him do things that he doesn't want to do. I will be right back.
I just hurt myself by accident.
I would go on Easter egg hunts, though. I love Easter. I would go on all sorts of egg hunts. Scavenger. Just finding the eggs out in the yard, whatever. Nowadays, if I get a basket, it's just handed to me, so not as exciting as it could be. And I don't always get a basket. No, I don't think so. If I was going to do what I was originally going to do for my sister-in-law, then yes, but I'm not doing that anymore. I'll see how these in-laws enjoyed the wine. I'll let you know. I do have a box for you, though, still. Somebody's making popcorn without me. Thanks for sending me bungalow packages. Cats are trying to get into my craft room. One of them got in the other day. Not supposed to be in here. Thankfully, he didn't terrorize anything too badly. I'm gonna finish painting these bases. I'm gonna see how the rhinestone looks on my prototype. And then I'll probably work on these at some point after Easter. Or if I get through tomorrow's super stream night quickly. I don't think I will, though. Got a lot to do. Just had a friend message me asking if he could have some of my mini potatoes because he wants to send a wedding invitation to Sean Astin. Potatoes. Which is funny because Sean Astin has already seen my potatoes because somebody bought potatoes from me and worked them into a cross stitch and then had them sign the cross stitch. Him and what's his face? Oh, I can't think of his name. Doesn't matter. But they've seen my potatoes and they said they were very cool, and celebrities have seen my miniatures, so I can, you know, I can die happy. Not the celebrities I would hope have seen my miniatures, but you know, whatever. Beggars can't be choosers. But it's been a running joke that we were going to send tiny potatoes to Sean Astin, and I guess it's going in the form of wedding invitations. That's fun. I don't think there's enough paint in my fingers. I think there can be significantly more paint in my fingers. And, I should really try harder to get more paint on my fingers. Yeah, okay, I like it. Let's hope that it still stays up straight. That hasn't.
Yeah. Alright.
So we got a prototype done at least. I think it's cute. And I'm not usually one for, like, cheesy wedding decor. So I would think that it would go... Let me get a piece of furniture out here first. So say you were doing like something like that, and then you would have like all your wedding cards out, or bouquet, or something. I'm trying to see if I have anything else that I could put up. I don't. Hmm. see, no, because I don't even have a lot of wedding stuff. But you would have, like, your birdcage, and you would have, like, maybe presents. Oh, I do have that. Hold on.
Wait. Wait.
That says happy birthday, but don't mind that. Cake. It's gifts. And bringing out the vintage birdcage that my mom made. See? Cute, right? That could work. It could be something. Pictures of the bride and groom. I don't know. It's your dollhouse. Make it work. But that's our first wedding decoration that we're gonna make. I've got two more in mind. And I'll be streaming hopefully same time tomorrow night, 7:30. 7:30, 8 o'clock. I don't know. Depends. Thanks. Yeah, mini pictures, right? Could work. Hey, people make a lot of things in miniatures now, so who am I to say what people are going to do? I honestly, one of my things about my big house is that I've got pieces that represent people in my life. Whoa, voice lossage. Excuse me. In my big house, I have people represented by certain items. Like, I've got a working music box that represents my grandfather, and I've got a few pieces that represent my brother, and a few pieces that represent my dad. My grandmother is represented by the flowers out front, and my memes is represented by the kaleidoscope that works in the attic. It's one of the things, and I want to get a piece to represent Rob, but I haven't been able to set the money aside to do it. I want to get my wedding bouquet, made in miniature, and I thought that would be really cool, but I have the artist picked out. I know who I want to do it, I just haven't had the money to, so but people get all sorts of things in miniature now, so I think this would be a cute addition to a wedding or bridal shower room box or scene. Or if your dolls just got married or whatever. But dolls, bears, whatever you have in your dollhouse. Yeah. So I'm gonna call it a night. We're gonna do another night of the Super Stream tomorrow night at 7:30 or 8 o'clock or something like that. We'll figure it out. You'll see me on. if you follow me. I'm not going to do the spiel because I have to do the spiel on Sunday. So if you need to know more about me, check it out in the About Me page. I hope everybody has a good rest of their Friday, and if I don't see you the rest of the weekend, happy Easter, if you celebrate. Have a great night, everybody. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.